Welcome to my next video on invoice verification in SAP MM. In my previous video, we had learnt about the overview of credit memos and reversals, which is part number 4 of the subsequent debits, credits, delivery costs and credit memos of invoice verification. Now we will go to the next section, where we will learn how to post a credit memo for a invoice. Let us go to our exercise sheet here. This is my exercise sheet here. There is a PO 45000180029 with 2 line items. Vendor has delivered 15 pieces of the 20 pieces of line item 10 and delivered full quantity of 10 pieces of line item 20. Vendor has already invoiced for full PO quantity of 20 pieces of item 10 and 10 pieces of item 20. The vendor has discovered that he is no longer able to supply the 5 pieces of line item 10 of PO that has already been invoiced for the purchase order. Therefore, he sends a credit memo. Enter the credit memo. Which items does the system propose? What are the proposed quantities and values? And finally, post the credit memo for the 5 pieces of the line item number 10. So now, let us go to SAP system and go to the transaction code Miro and post credit memo for the 5 pieces of the line item number 10. So here, I am in SAP here. I am already in the transaction code Miro. First, we have to select transaction as credit memo. This is the first step. Then input the document date. Today is 30th August. Here reference number 18029/credit memo. This is the last 5 digits of our purchase order number 18029. And then select the tax code. Our tax code is S2 here. S2. So let us cross check the tax code here from the PO. I am in the PO here. If we select, go to the invoice here, tax code is S2 for the line item number 10 and line item 20 also, it is S2. Now, if we see the PO history of the purchase order, for the line item number 10, the quantity is 20 pieces and the quantity delivered by the vendor is 15 pieces only. And the quantity invoiced is 20 full PO quantity of 20 pieces. This is for the line item number 10. For the item number 20, the PO quantity is 10 pieces and the GR quantity is 10 pieces. We have received the full PO quantity of 10 pieces and invoice is also posted for the full PO quantity of 10 pieces. So, for item number 20, there is no issue. Only for item number 10, out of the 20 pieces in the PO, vendor has delivered only 15 pieces and we have already invoiced for 20 pieces. Now, vendor is saying that he is not able to deliver the remaining 5 pieces out of the 20 pieces and he has sent a credit memo for the 5 pieces of the line item number 10. Now, we will post that credit memo here. So, here, tax code is fine, right? So, let us go to the PO reference tab page, input the PO number 45000180029. Just press enter. So, as soon as you press enter, system will suggest the full quantity which is already invoice. That is the invoice quantity total of the line item 10, which is 20 pieces, and line item number 20, which is 10 pieces. Now, what we need to do? We need to select only the item number 10 and put the quantity as 5 and the amount as 500 because each piece is 100 rupees. And we should deselect the item number 2 from the invoice and then we have to press enter and then we have to post the invoice after simulate. So, what I will do? I am in the invoice transaction code here. So, don't select item number 20 because this is already delivered and also invoiced correctly. Only we have issued line item number 10. Here, we have to post a credit memo for 5 pieces. Change the quantity to 5 and the amount to 500. Because if you see the PO here, I will show you again, the amount for each piece is 100 rupees. So for 5 pieces, it is 500 rupees, right? So put the amount here 500, then enter. See, after I deselect the item number 2, system has selected only the first line item, which is 5 pieces and 500 rupees for the line item number 10 of the PO. Now balance is 500. So let me calculate tax, which is 10%. Just click calculate tax. It is 50 rupees. Now what is the total amount? Total amount is 500 plus 50, which is 550 rupees. This total amount we have to post for the credit memo. Okay. Now I will click simulate. These are the account moments. So 550 rupees, which will go to the vendor account, 500 to the GRIR clearing account, and 50 rupees to the tax GL account for the tax input tax. These are the account movements. Back. Now I will post the invoice. Just click post. Once the credit memo is posted, the same will be updated in the purchase order history. And we can see the accounting document for the credit memo document. Once the credit memo is posted, let us go to the purchase order history and we will see this credit memo document. So this is already posted. The credit memo document is 510-560-9809. So let me go to the PO here. So just click display change. Again click display change. Now go to the item detail. Here we can see the credit memo document. This is the credit memo posted for the 5 pieces of the line item 10, which is for amount of 500 rupees. We can go to the accounting document. Just click on the credit memo. This is the credit memo. And if you want to go to the accounting document, click on follow on documents. Double click on the accounting document. These are the account movements. So 550 rupees, that is vendor has to pay us back. And this is 500 rupees for the GRIR clearing account. Material account, which is minus sign, we can see here. 50 rupees for the input tax account, which is again we can see here minus sign here. So this is the account movements for the credit memo document. So this is how to post the credit memo for a invoice which is already posted. Thank you for watching my video. Please give me your valuable comments, likes, and please subscribe to my channel so that you will get notification of my upcoming videos on several scenarios in MM. Thanks for your time. See you in my next video.